Thomas Sports Talk Worldwide with some news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Now let's go up to heavyweights. This is a quick one, y'all. You know, we got the Deontay Wilder, Tyson Fury rematch in limbo now. Tyson Fury got the huge deal. Everybody seems to be up to speed on that. He got a huge deal, and that fight's not imminent anymore. We don't know. But let's make sure we make sure that we don't get caught up in a narrative that they have to push out there, right? ESPN and the likes. The narrative is going to have to be that there's some kind of network struggle, right, going on. Like there's some network beef happening, right? Now, networks are always beefing. So that's the way that it is, right? But we know, and we're not going to forget that, Deontay Wilder is a free agent in that. He can go and fight there. So it's not an issue. It's a non-issue. But mind you, it will continue to be said. That will be the narrative that they're hoping that the casual fan digest, right? And then they just say, okay, cool. And then most of these people are, you know, that's doing their thing is going to regurgitate that mess. That's not an issue for that fight. That fight can happen still, even though Tyson Fury signed with ESPN. But be careful of that narrative, you know, and like at the end of the day, here's something else. Tyson Fury, bottom line, this fight doesn't happen right away. Fans going to be disappointed. And let me be sure that, you know, people kind of have to, you know, this is going to come Tyson Fury's way, you know, because Tyson Fury was just saying 6 to 8 weeks ago that Anthony Joshua was the golden goose, that, you know, they don't want to risk fights because, you know, hey, they got to keep the train, the gravy train going. You know, I mean, remember he was calling them golden goose. Well, you goosing right about now, you know. I don't know if it's golden, the silver, moving up to gold, that's going to come Tyson Fury's way if that does not happen. But actually, you know, for me personally, it doesn't even matter. You know, people want to have a fight or not. If they don't, then, you know, whatever. You know, but those are things that are going to happen. And I'm just saying, even though Ortiz doesn't say something about Tyson Fury, you know, and say, hey, you know, he's not a Tyson Fury. He's trying to get these fights, you know, because people are starting to see what's going on. That's what happens. You're going to, you know, backlash. Hey, bottom line, though, Tyson Fury got paid. And if he can have other fights, then he's probably going to probably do that, you know, but I just think the networks are going to be saying, hold up, you know, there ain't like a whole lot of people know Tyson Fury yet, and you better fight somebody that they know, you know, so two unknowns, you know, justifying $30 million going to be hard to do. So that's what we can take solace in that. That'll probably help us get good fights. But I'm just saying, y'all, right now, when you read articles like I have, right, they try to slip that narrative in there like, oh, you know, because of the networks, it's, you know, it's not going to happen. That's programmed. They're doing that on purpose. Don't fall for it. The fight can happen. Deontay Wilder has shown, already have said it, among others, and within the negotiations, that wouldn't be an issue if they want to have the fight immediately. Probably if you start trying to dictate what Wilder does, you know, hey, let's have an interim fight, let's do this, let's do that. No, that's something. But if the fight was to happen now, that wouldn't be an issue. So be careful with that. Just like when Deontay Wilder and Anthony Joshua had negotiations, people were trying to continually say, well, they had a problem and the negotiations broke down in the summer instead of just saying what happened. You know, one offer $50 million, he didn't take it. And then he tried to sign $15 million. And then Povetkin was put in his way by the WBA. Same people I was talking about in another video, right? But at the end of the day, things happen, and that's the way it is. Now, Tyson Fury, he's going to get that backlash for sure because things, they stick. $50 million is sticking with Joshua. You know, he's at press conferences, and when people ask him that question, he's getting irked. But the question is just going to come. And then, you know, you've heard that some people weren't even supposed to be able to get in. YouTubers and people that are doing their thing that might ask these pertinent questions are not even allowed in because they're going to come. That one with Tyson Fury, you know, it's going to come. It's going to happen, you know, but people are going to start saying, you know, wait, wasn't you talking about a golden goose about, you know, eight weeks ago? Now things have changed. You're the golden goose. That could possibly happen to him. But, you know, I'm run up on Fury. Fury can talk back to you. So let's just see what happens. I thought that was pertinent. Don't Sports Talk. Worldwide. And I'm about to hear y'all.